The stock market, Dow Jones Industrial Average, just hit 30,000. We've never broken 30,000. The stock market's just broken 30,000. That's a sacred number, 30,000.
That's right. Last week, the Dow Jones has passed a sacred number, a symbolic milestone of 30,000. The stock market as a whole has been on an up and up since the March lows. And with all this excitement and news headlines, it's not surprising that a lot of people are trying their hands at investing for the first time. And for many young investors, you know, they want to invest in companies as making a difference in the world on issues like climate change and gun violence. And thankfully, you don't have to sort through thousands of companies to find those that meet your criteria. All you have to do is invest in an ESG fund. ESG investing, or sustainable investing, has seen a massive inflow of money, even passing $1 trillion for the first time ever in August. And I'm using the term ESG investing and sustainable investing interchangeably, but for everyone who doesn't know, ESG stands for Environmental, Social, and Corporate Governance. Research firm MSCI breaks them down further by saying environmental means climate change, natural resources, pollution and waste, environmental opportunities, and social includes human capital, product liability, stakeholder opposition, and social opportunities. And finally, the governance part, it means corporate governance and corporate behavior as a whole. Sounds good, right? ESG funds, they make investing into responsible companies easy, and you also get to change the world by supporting companies that are making a difference. But, and this is a big one, sorry to break it to you guys, but only half of that statement is true. It's true that ESG funds make it easy to invest, but the companies that they hold, well, let's just say they're not squeaky clean. Because publicly traded companies, they exist for one reason, is to make money for the shareholders. And as you can imagine, that often leads to shady history and scandals that'll make your skin crawl and make you wonder, how in the world is that company allowed in an ESG fund? So let's get right into it and see what kind of companies can be found in a typical ESG fund. And because there's hundreds of ESG funds to choose from, I'm just going to look at the ESG funds that's held in M1 Finance, which happens to be the brokerage that I use. And side note, I've done an in-depth review on M1 Finance in this video, and if you want to open your account, just make sure you use my referral link in the description so you can get $10 totally free just by opening and funding a free M1 Finance account. And while we're at it, don't forget to like and subscribe to stay updated on my investing journey as well. Anyway, on M1 Finance Expert Pies tab, you can choose from a bunch of curated portfolios, with one of them offering sound financial options for the socially responsible investor. Try saying that 5 times. And as a socially responsible investor, you click on it, and for right now, we're going to go with the responsible investing portfolio. And look at that. Not only are you investing in an ESG fund that benefits the world, but you also get a nice return of 62.87% over the past 5 years. So this portfolio, it utilizes the new shares ESG funds. And even though there are 5 different funds, I'm just going to look at the companies held in these 2, since they include larger companies most of us will be familiar with. And let's get right into it with the first one, which is NULG, NUV's ESG Large Cap Growth ETF. This is their official website for this fund. If you scroll a bit down, you get here, which lists the companies that is held into this specific fund. And remember, ESG is supposed to hold companies that have positive impact on society, environment, and corporate governance. So let's see what amazing companies this ESG fund holds. NULG, it holds 86 different holdings. In the first and second place, we have Alphabet, which is of course the parent company of Google and YouTube, making up 7.41% of this ETF. I'm going to go through each company's scandals and controversies quickly to save time, but you can always dive deeper since I'm just going to highlight the most common criticisms. Anyway, did you know that Alphabet paid Andy Rubin, who was the creator of Android mobile software, a $90 million exit package, even though he's been accused of sexual misconduct? And Google has also been fined numerous times by the European Union for abusing its market dominance in mobile, for manipulating shopping search results, and anti-competitive practices against other search engines. And how can we forget about YouTube's whole debacle of advertising to kids, which resulted in a $170 million fine? And let's touch on something more recent. YouTube, it updated its terms of services, saying it has the right to monetize all content on its platform. Meaning for someone like me, who doesn't have the 1,000 subs and 4,000 watch hours to be monetized yet, YouTube can start showing ads on my videos without having to pay me anything. And yeah, YouTube has a right to do whatever it wants on this platform, but come on, YouTube, like, seriously, come on. Next, we have Tesla, the most polarizing stock in the history of stocks. First, we have Elon Musk calling a British diver a pedophile, which was just so mind-boggling it made all the news headlines back in 2018. Also, Tesla workers, they take twice as many days off because of injuries and sickness, with Lori Shelby, who is Tesla's VP of Environmental Health and Safety, telling Bloomberg that the most important metric is fatalities and our number is zero. And let's just say, I think we're all glad that no one has died from building a Model 3 yet. And more recently, after downplaying the severity of the ongoing pandemic, Elon Musk, he pushed to reopen Tesla's Fremont factory against local public health guidelines, going as far as to file a federal lawsuit. And let's move on to Nike. Good old Nike. We all remember Nike's sweatshops, and it's still continuing today, unfortunately, with numerous work violations, including wage theft, bribes, unsafe work environment, and more being reported in factories all over Asia. Nike has recently been in hot water following reports of forced labors of Chinese Muslim minority group in its factories. We also have Bristol Myers, the pharmaceutical giant, facing a $1 billion lawsuit over its roles in the 1940s US government experiment that infected hundreds of Guatemalans with syphilis. UNLG also hosts Electronic Arts, one of the most hated companies in the world, who, surprise surprise, is being sued by its employees for unpaid overtime, sometimes up to 100 hours a week, during periods known as crunch time. And let's move on to that second ETF on M1 Finance's responsible investing portfolio. And this one is NULV, which is Nuvve's ESG Large Cap Value ETF. And once again, if we scroll down, we find all the different companies this value ETF holds. At the very top, we have Procter & Gamble, consumer goods giant and part of every dividend investor's portfolio. But did you know that P&G has a dark past where its tampons led to toxic shock syndrome that killed 38 people? And we also have them importing and using palm oils, which has been harvested with child labor and also forced labor. And to add salt to injury, they also contributed to destruction of natural habitats to make room for massive palm oil farms, which further led to pollution and ecological losses. And tucked away in NULV, we also have Coca-Cola and Pepsi. And where do we begin with these two? How about both soda companies? They funded health groups, but also blocked legislations to reduce the consumption of soft drinks. And Coca-Cola is the most polluting brand, contributing to more than 3 million tons of plastic waste each year. And when asked about that, they shifted the blame on the consumer, saying that, hey, people really like their resealable single-use plastic bottles. In addition to mirroring what Coca-Cola has done, PepsiCo, they also dabbled in some palm oil controversies. NULV also hosts BlackRock, who is the world's largest asset manager with $7.4 trillion under its belt. And on a positive note, BlackRock was a big component in pushing for ESG investing, which is great. And they've also taken steps to address climate change by selling $500 million of their coal investments. Sounds great, right? A good all-around company. And they would be, if it wasn't for the fact that BlackRock still has $11 billion invested in coal companies. But, you know, hooray for divesting $500 million. There's also the reality that BlackRock has major investments in aerospace and defense companies, as well as some gun manufacturers. So yeah, not only does the biggest asset manager in the world who pushed ESG investing, they don't adhere to the ESG guidelines. ESG funds as a whole, they're filled with companies that have past scandals and current controversies that go against what it means to be ESG. But maybe you're willing to give all the companies I just mentioned a pass. You're willing to overlook Alphabet, Tesla, Nike, Bristol Myers, Electronic Arts, Procter & Gamble, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, and BlackRock. But let's go back to M1 Finance and go to the International Responsible Investing Portfolio. Making up 15% of this portfolio is NUDM, which is Nuvve's ESG International Developed Market Equity ETF. Such a mouthful. But if you go onto their website and you scroll down to NUMD's top portfolio position, who do you see at the very top? You find Nestle, making up 3.16% of the portfolio. I mean, Nestle? Seriously? This ESG fund has Nestle as its top holdings. Let me tell you a few things about Nestle. Nestle CEO, he doesn't believe that water is a human right and should be privatized. Nestle tried to downplay the environmental damage caused by his bottled water. Nestle's former CEO was accused of fixing the price of cocoa beans. And Nestle also steals water from public land and then reaps billions of dollars in profit while leaving the locals in the dust. And there's also the time when this multi-billion dollar corporation tried to force Ethiopia to repay a $6 million loan while Ethiopia was going through a famine. So yeah, when an ESG's fund's top holding is Nestle, I just have to laugh out loud when people say ESG investing and sustainable investing invest in companies that benefit the world. I think I bashed on ESG investing enough already, so let's try to end on a bit of a positive note. Like I said, I think it's great that ESG investing or any kind of investing style is attracting people to start their investing journey because taking control of your financial future is important, and that's something that I preach on my videos every single day. But saying that ESG investing only picks socially responsible companies is a big fat lie. That's like saying you love celebrating Earth Day and you love Mother Earth while doing nothing to save it during the other 364 days of the year. This is a definition of corporate greenwashing. But anyway, know what you're investing in before you start your journey in sustainable investing. And if you are holding any ESG funds, try digging a bit deeper and do your research to see what companies they actually hold. Because you'll be surprised to find where your socially responsible dollars are actually going into. And I'm sorry if this video was a bit depressing, but don't worry, I know what's going to cheer you guys up. If this video made you angry and you want to smash something, take your anger out on the like button and the subscribe button. And don't forget to claim your free $10 when you use your referral links below to open up your free M1 Finance account so you can research and find a socially responsible company to invest that $10 in. That's all I have for you guys today. Happy investing. Stay safe as always. I'll catch you next time with better news and more financial shenanigans.